It's not the volume of word, it's what you receive.
Amen. Mm.
And actually use. He didn't say, man shall live by hearing the word. He said, man shall live by? See, you live by it, by doing it, using it. And it produces miracles and breakthroughs. So when I make statements, I'm not trying to attack anyone. I'm just telling you, when I don't see the breakthroughs of God, the miracles of God, when I see poverty in your life, I know you're not submitted to me. Because I'm carrying that grace and that covenant. And He's on everything I do. No one has ever connected with me who remained the same. No ministry. I'm the only preacher I know that will go to places, instead of receiving money, I carry my money. God said, take your money. Go give to them. Tell them not to spend it, but to deposit it in their account. He said, the glory on it will break the yokes in their ministry. I went to a guy's church, and that morning before I went to preach, I saw these huge white boards, and they were flapping in the wings. In the wind. But they are all separate. I said, Lord, what are these? He said, these are the satanic barricades that had held His ministry, so He can't get anywhere. All they have accomplished by their fasting and prayer is to break it loose. But it's still there, banging them back. He said, give them $1,000. He said, the glory on your money will break that thing.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. George, can I use your testimony?
Amen.
You have to tell it right now. Now you see? I was leaving the men's meeting, and the young man came to me.
Hallelujah.
He said, I need your money. Just give me $1. And I gave him $1. And he put it in his billfold. Now, let him come tell you what God did.
Hallelujah.
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 Do you have courage to accomplish great things?
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yeah? In resurrection, you don't go chasing anything. It comes to you.
Amen.
Do you mind helping us? That's the way it comes. Somebody else had that contract, and they messed over it. And the lady fired them and gave it to this man. And the man is going through his phone, and God caused his name to jump out. That's who the contract belongs to. Off of one anointed dollar. Why? Because God said so.
Amen.
I told you that the miracles begin by developing your relationship with God. So you can hear God say, go get a dollar from Him. You must hear from God. His testimony is like this that makes me not pay attention to naysayers.
Amen.
And dumb heads making noise.
Amen.
I said, go away from me with your poverty.
Amen.
And frustrations. I want children who want to be blessed.
Amen.
You want a blessing? Get under me.
Amen.
God will change your life and change your generation. Hallelujah. The same way we don't harass anybody or make noise about any money. That's supernatural. God is cultivating it in the house.
Amen.
So when we start stadium crusades, I told you each crusade will cost $1 million. Bill Winston is doing it now. He said it costs $1.2 million each. And they do one a month. So you need money. You can't fry enough chickens.
Amen.
to do this. You need real money. And in Christendom, you know what I've noticed? People who don't have money are the people that make the most noise about preachers and money. It says because you're broke. If you are blessed, hallelujah. There is nothing you will not do for God. There's nothing. Hallelujah. All right. Just a few minutes. Joshua 1, and then we'll close.
Hallelujah.
Now, after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spake unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise, go over this Jordan, thou and all this people, unto the land which I do give to them, even to the children of Israel. Every place. You notice we are walking that land. Every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses. Notice, generational. From the wilderness. See, they had the boundary angels. From the wilderness and this Lebanon, even unto the great river, the river Euphrates, or the land of the Hittites, and unto the great sea, toward the going down of the sun, shall be your coast. This is what President Carter said years ago when in the Middle East peace negotiations. He said, please, let's not bring the Bible in. Because if you bring the Bible, it will lead to world war. Because Israel did not get the land when God told him to. So now all these countries have formed. Jordan. Even Iraq. Lebanon. Those are all the land that God gave Israel. So he said, we can't bring the Bible into it, he said. It would just cause a world war. Hallelujah. You see, there shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee, nor forsake thee. Be strong and of a good courage. For unto this people shalt thou divide for an inheritance the land, which I swear unto their fathers to give them. Only be thou strong, very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law, which Moses my servant commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest. Every time I read it, I stop here to say it. So you hear anyone that's so upset when you talk about prosperity, you know they are not a son of God. Because every covenant God gives, he didn't say that you will just prosper. He said, everywhere you turn, prosperity. I said, which Bible are you reading? You're practicing your religion. I remember years ago, even though I haven't prayed or anything, when Spears' father was getting married, and he had some of his friends, I don't know, from Ohio, Catholics, or whatever they were, and they came into Pastor Wayne's office. Pastor Wayne had all these very expensive furnishings, you know, in his office, that one guy, you know, told him, he said, Pastor, you know, I have this very expensive furniture. I don't have any place to keep it. I'd like to just put it in your office until I'll take it back. I don't know that he ever came to take it back. So this guy came into Pastor Wayne's office. Do you know what this ignoramus said? Where's the poverty? Huh? Where's the poverty? I say, you devil. You mean you came into God's house and you're looking for poverty as a sign of righteousness? You see how convoluted and inverted Satan is? And religious people are. Where is the poverty? I said, you're in the wrong place. If it was me getting married, I would say, sit out, because I don't want poverty to enter my marriage. Keep your devils. Where is the poverty? I say you're in the wrong place. Even though I wasn't the pastor. I had to straighten him out. I say, you are? You don't have any business here. Go to a place where the roof is leaking. And the pastor is begging you for money. But in the Abrahamic covenant, hallelujah, you're blessed going in, coming out. Hallelujah. Everywhere, he says. Father, thank you for blessing us, changing our lives, opening our eyes, transforming us. Don't let any of us remain the same. May religion die in this house. And let glory reign. We thank you, Lord, for it. In Jesus' name. Now watch. Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law which Moses my servant commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand or to the left. You notice? He said, don't turn from what I told you. Amen. Why? There are naysayers everywhere. Yeah. Deceivers everywhere. Religious people. Amen. Opinionated people. Relatives. Amen. Calling me a cult. Amen. Don't turn. Amen. To the right hand or to the left. Amen. In America, you qualify as a cult if I don't understand what you're doing. Nobody goes to church this much. You got to be a cult over there. Because you go to church once a month. Oh, Easter and Christmas. No breakthrough, no blessing, no nothing. You just have your name on the roll. And when the roll is called up yonder, you will not be there. Because if you are not there now, you won't be there over there. Hallelujah. Watch now. Where am I? 8, okay? This book of the law shall not depart. So don't let it depart out of your mouth. You see that that's the war of Satan. You have pain. He wants you to keep saying, I have pain. So you saying you have pain will keep that pain there. That's what we were not taught. So don't let the word, I have pain, but by the stripes of Jesus, I'm healed. He said, don't let it depart out of your mouth. The enemy is trying to force it out of your mouth. You have an attack. You say, you are not blessed. I'm blessed. Going in, coming out. Don't let it depart out of your mouth. If you're not confessing the word every day, you will not have breakthroughs. If you don't practice the covenants of Resurrection House, I told you that an offense is a trigger on a trap. So the enemy is constantly trying to offend you so he can pounce. But if you humble yourself, keep your mouth shut, and take the wrong, boo, God moves. When you hear me say, I'm a son of Abraham, I am not under the prejudices of man, amen, the discriminations of man. My breakthrough is my answer. Amen. A tale of two cities. I said that Joyce Myers is probably the richest minister in America. She got all the women with all the money. She's the only one, she built her own Colosseum, cash. She's the only one that flies an airliner. But watch, when Juanita Bynum was, you know, running high or whatever, she went to borrow money from the bank to build a Colosseum. And the Bible says we should pay attention to children of the devil when it comes to money. He said, they don't understand money. Jesus said that. It's not the devil that said that. He said, the children of the world are wiser when it comes to money than my children. Do you know what the banker told Juanita Bynum? These things are facts. You know, you can Google it. Amen. Watch. He says, you don't have anything.
Wow.
She said, look at my financials. He said, you don't have anything. He said, you are one comment away from a scandal. You're one incident away from a scandal. And all these things will vanish. And we will not be able to get our money back. And it happened exactly as the banker said. That's why I said it's the tale of two cities. Those of you that went to school, you remember Charles Dickens. It was the best of times. And it was the worst of times. Mm-hmm. All right. I don't know. Tell me what verse. I'm still at verse 8. This book of the law, yes, shall not depart. I told you the warfare is, I don't like calling his name. The enemy keeps trying to get the word out of you. Whether he does it through pain, rejection, suffering, somebody makes a comment. He wants to get the word out of your mouth. So he would take the miraculous out of your mouth. Every time I'm in a crisis, I come and stand here, whether you're here or not, and I begin to declare the way it will go.
Amen.
Not based on the circumstance, based on what God already said.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look at what he just said to me. He said, tell them, you are the blessed. Satan is trying to curse.
Amen.
You are the healed. Satan is trying to make sick. You have to receive who you are. You are not your circumstance. You are the son of Abraham. Jesus paid for you to have it. So this book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth. Don't stop quoting it. He's done it to me. He'll do it to you. He'll make you feel like you're wasting time. Don't you see anything changing? Don't worry. It's to you, it's not changing. I said, remember, Israel walked around the wall for 7 days, and it looked like nothing is happening. But at the appointed time, God said, shout! And the wall fell. Hallelujah. Huh? The Holy Spirit says, isn't that time for you to shout every wall down in your life? I'm going to keep shouting until you fall. I'm going to keep shouting until your power breaks off of me. I'm going to keep shouting until my body is healed. I will keep shouting until I prosper. I will keep shouting, woo, until I take back everything the devil stole from me. Hallelujah! Glory. I preach myself happy. God has sunk every devil fighting me all these years. I've watched enemies come and go, dropping like flies, year after year, but they never stop. So you haven't learned anything from all those resting in peace, fighting the God of Resurrection House for all nations? So you lost your mind. He said to Joshua, no man shall be able. In other words, they will try it, but God will cut them down.
Amen.
This is a blessing movement. that will impact the whole earth. Amen. We're just in the dress rehearsal. God said, I'll fill stadiums. And all you have to do is lift your hand. And you're going to see 100,000 people hit the ground. It's a permanent deposit. Whether I pray it or don't pray. Even if I'm limping on one leg, I will overcome that devil messing with you. I celebrate the covenant of God. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth. Thou shalt meditate therein.
Amen.
I was telling them years ago, I saw Pastor Kreffler. He had prostate cancer twice. And he went into a hotel. He gathered all his teachings on healing and the scriptures on tape. And he put the thing in his ears. And for 7 days, nonstop, he barraged himself with his own preaching on healing. Yeah. Kenneth Copeland, Kenneth Hagin, the Word of God, directly, for 7 days. And he came out and went to the doctor. They tested him. He was cancer-free. Yeah. Watch. And then after a few years, the cancer reattacked. And he went back into the hotel and did the same thing again. And went back to the doctor and tested cancer free. Me? I didn't go to no hotel. I didn't put anything in my ears. Hallelueh. I didn't go through chemotherapy. The cancer came. And I determined I will not flinch. I will keep doing what God gave me to do. Amen. And by the time I got to the surgery, cancer was gone. Amen. He says, should not depart out of your mouth. You should meditate on it. Not on your problems. You meditate on it. Day and night. Day and night. Day and night. Hallelujah. Beloved, the covenant of Abraham is filled with blessings and no curses. If you have been deceived by religious devils to believe that poverty is part of God's covenant, then you need deliverance. The Word of God promises nothing else but prosperity and blessing. Where have you found curses for God's children in the Abrahamic covenant, in what the Lord Jesus promised? Where? Why are you so angry when you see a prosperous person in the Lord Jesus Christ? Isn't it that you don't know how to get into yours? He said, take the word of God, read it, meditate on it day and night, so you will observe to do it. He says, it should not depart from your mouth. You don't know that Satan has been tricking you all these years by putting your problems in your mouth instead of the word of God in your mouth. He knows what God says. He knows how to trick you and then incarcerate you. Keep the word in your mouth no matter how you feel. By the stripes of Jesus I'm healed. My God shall supply all my need according to his riches in glory, not according to the job. I know you've been on these jobs all your life. And some of you have never made more than $30,000 a year. So when you hear prosperity, you think it's not possible. If God does not break you through beyond your job, then you haven't found the realm of prosperity. Because God finds a way to bless you. He said, I'll bless the work of your hands. Anything you touch shall prosper. How can you desire anything else? You should know that whatever you put your hands on, prosperity will get on it. God will open avenues of blessing unto you, connect you with relationships that will bring resources unto you. You don't chase the resource. You don't chase the blessing. You chase after God. You do what he's telling you, and then watch him move. Watch him
That's why up to tomorrow, I am not chasing anything. I'm not trying to connect with no one. I'm not doing any of that. I am self-contained in the Lord my God. And I'm teaching you how to get your own. That's a blessing with your name on it. A guy sings a song that, like that here at Resurrection House for All Nations. I celebrate the blessing of Abraham. I celebrate the covenant of Resurrection House for All Nations. Come to the Conquest Conference. Find God again in a new dimension, in a new light. Hallelujah. Finding God in these confused times. Finding God in these turbulent times. When you discover him, he fills all the gaps in your soul. You are made complete in him. 770-994-3777. That's your breakthrough prayer line. That's your seed sowing line. That's your miracle deliverance line. All the information on the screen. I keep telling you, if you don't put a seed down into the soil of this ministry, you won't experience the power and the glory that's on it. You may look down on it. That's your loss. Or you submit to it and you find what others have found. Act on it today and shame the devil, and we will rejoice with you. If you have sown before, sow again. Sow consistently every month. Make it a covenant, and may God move for you and deliver you. Amen. I am telling you what I've experienced. I'm telling you what has worked for me. I'm telling you what has worked for Resurrection House for All Nations. We are completely debt-free. We own property. We own a private jet. We own a high-performance propeller plane. What hasn't God done with 300 people? I wish I had 5,000. We will buy America. The glory will be so strong. We'll have 100, 200 million, you know. My God. Eh? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Come and learn what others have learned, and your life will not remain the same. In the name of the Father, Son, Jesus, and the Holy Ghost. Receive in Jesus' name. Amen. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.